Ciao guys,
and welcome back to Lampis. In this video, as you can see, we are in the middle of our safari trip. We wanted to share with you some Namibian travel tips, like for first time visitors to Namibia. If you're planning to visit Namibia or to do safari in Namibia, what do you need to know?
Exactly, so stay with us, Emma. As you can see, we are in the middle of the Namibian National Park, the Waterberg Plateau, and we are camping. So we
in central Namibia.
So we actually know what we are talking about.
Yeah, not only that, we've done safari before. This is our second safari, and we always do kind of major safaris in Namibia. Of course, it's home, but it's also a very nice place for safari experience. So I think, for the first time, or first important thing you need to know about Namibia is driving.
Driving, yes.
When it comes to driving, I want to highlight the time that you're going to stay on the road.
Yeah.
So it is, the towns are very far away from each other just because the country is so huge with few people. So for example, to drive between, let me say today,
Oshiwarongo and Katima.
Yes. It's about, I would say about
9 hours
or 10 hours of depending
drive.
On how many stops you have made.
800 kilometers. The biggest problem is not really the distance, the biggest problems are the animals on the street. Those you really need to take your precautions and drive with cautions. Like always slow down, both for farming animal you are going to find on the street, so cows and goat. And of course, wildest animal like guinea fowls and wartong. Those are really...
Or sometimes kudus.
Yeah.
Huge antelopes on the road, and sometimes elephants. If you're so driving in terms of time, distance, and speed limit. Now, we have a couple of tar roads.
Yeah.
And I have to highlight the good thing about Namibian roads is that they are all straight.
Straight. The roads are really well maintained and they are straight, and the tar is brand new, is because most of the Namibian road are new. But the tricky things is that make you feel like comfortable and make you speed faster. But really, guys, stay within the limits, under than 20, because the faster you drive, the more chances you have to hit animals, and it's not fun, because guinea fowls can only damage the car, but a wartong cannot actually kill you, because
if it can lose control,
and then a holiday can transform to a tragedy in a few seconds. So please be careful when you are driving in Namibia. Don't speed.
Yes. Another thing is on this gravel road. So traveling to tourist lodges, to national park, these are gravel roads, and on gravel roads, maximum 80. These are loose gravel. It's very difficult to actually keep the car straight.
Yes.
So again, here, drive with caution. So you have loose gravel, and you have, again, a lot of wildlife, especially baboons, guinea fowls, wartong on the gravel roads, because
yes,
it's more wild.
Even a giraffe, you didn't nominate giraffe, but
yes,
also giraffe on the road.
Roadblocks in Africa. These are the things that you should watch out for. You don't need to speed. Just imagine what will happen if you're speeding here 120 and you hit a giraffe.
Yeah, I know.
You basically need to go down the road and you do your safari there.
Yeah, that's true. I think you have to keep your eyes open all the time when you're driving.
Yeah, don't drive fast. Don't
120 drive fast. On gravel, 180. Keep your eyes open.
180
Excuse
on
me, no. So 120 on tar road, 80 kilometers per hour on the gravel road, and keep your eyes open all the time.
For
watch out for the animals. Yes. So another thing when it comes to camp or touring Namibia or visiting Namibia for the first time that I also want to discuss is vaccination.
Vaccination, yes.
What is important?
As a European, I can always say that when I'm thinking about Africa, we have this imaginary of we need to get all sorts of injection because there are the worst kind of sickness that you can get in the world. It's not like that, especially in Namibia, because it's a dry place. Mosquitoes are present just during summer, and if you were areas at the north, like the Zambezi region, Ex-Kabibi, and near the Victoria Falls, where there are rivers, of course, and there is the possibility for the mosquito to reproduce. For example, for us, we didn't get any vaccination, like me and my Italian friend, that during these 15 days, we didn't get any vaccination. And we actually brought some mosquito repellent, but we didn't even have the chance to use it.
Yeah, malaria is one of the things that you have to think of if you come into Namibia, because, of course, the north, eastern part of the country is a malaria area. Again, it depends on the season. If you're going there during winter, there's no need to take malarone. We wanted to take it, because of course I work for a pharmaceutical company. I was thinking about it and I went to the doctor to get the receipt. It is expensive, and the idea of, yeah, I have to take tablets for 15 days. Yeah, what if you don't even get a mosquito bite? So if you're going during winter, you don't need anything against malaria apart from
our
skin repellents.
Yeah, skin repellents is way more than enough.
But maybe when you're coming during the summer, I've been to Katima before during the summer in the Zambezi region, I know that there are mosquitoes. So
summer in Namibia, for you that you don't know the country and you have never visited Namibia, is between October and
May.
So that is the summer season, especially after December. There is these 2 months that is the raining season, where the whole country is more moisty and there are more chances for you to get mosquitoes bites.
Great. So malaria, maybe depending on the season, and I would also say for adults, you don't only need a repellent and then protective clothes, and that is sufficient. If you want to do safari in Namibia, is it a must to have a 4x4?
I would say no, because most of the roads are
gravel,
most of the roads are tar road, like most kilometers are tar road, and you just have few kilometers with gravel road, and mostly the gravel road in Namibia are really, really good. Normal sedan can easily go and drive safely on a gravel road in Namibia. There is no, if you want to do extreme things like going to Apupa Falls or going to some less known region, yes. But
so this is the thing, when it comes to a 4x4, it comes to an issue also of affordability and where you're going, and convenience.
Yes.
Now,
yes.
There are so many locals already on this road without 4x4. So if you're maybe a student and you're really on a budget, you can still do your trip with a sedan. If you are
A group of friends, I would say 4 people. If you have 4 people, it would be better for you and safer for you, of course, to rent a 4x4, because if you split the cost, that is affordable even for students, and is safer, of course, because you are renting a car that is actually made and thought to be driven on gravel, and you are not going to encounter problem is less likely that you are encountering a problem to have a flat tire or maybe to have some
damage.
Problem.
And if you're more adventurous, of course, when you're in a group, 4x4 is better. You have also more space, then you can also drive way faster. My point is just don't let the idea of not being able to afford a 4x4 prevent you from having safari. Because we have done a safari before
with a sedan,
and on those roads.
But we are crazy.
No, babe, it's not true. There are so many people on that road with a sedan. Because you know, you can go up to Sources Play with a sedan. Only that short strip, you need a 4x4, and most tourists with a 4x4, they are not experienced to drive that Sources Play.
Yeah, so they get stuck even with a
4x4. So if you can do that, it's fine. But that also brings us to our next point. The length of your holiday and the number, like, it's going to be way cheaper and convenient to be in a group. 4 people rent one car, saves a lot of money. and minutes are written, it's yeah. makes sense to visit Namibia at least, I would say, at least two weeks.
Less than that
is too expensive and it's
not worth it. That is for a simple reason. The place that you have to visit, they are the main attraction in Namibia as a country, are far away from each other. So it easily happened that you have to drive more than 600 kilometers from a place to the other. And that, of course, make a lot of time, like you are wasting a lot of time in the car during your holiday. So
Some days you only stay on the road, basically.
So you need to plan at least two weeks is the minimum time that you have to be in Namibia. Otherwise, you're just going to see maybe Tosha National Park, but that is not all Namibia. You cannot really say that I visited Namibia just because I visited Tosha. Okay, let me check the light.
Yes, but the light is fine, babe.
Let's close.
No,
How much things do you have?
No, one last thing.
I'm sweating.
Why are you sweating? Okay, another convenient, like, one thing that I really think is crazy. I've seen tourists in Namibia that hire or rent a GPS.
Yeah.
If I would say for a first timer, you honestly need a map, a paper map.
Like there are three roads in Namibia, basically. One that goes to the coast, one that that crosses the country, like from the south to the north, and the other one that goes to the Caprivi Strip. They are the main roads.
And the roads are always straight. You can go everywhere
with this road.
Yes, they are always straight. You don't need a GPS. So just buy a simple map and that's it. And I'm sure even with that simple map, you maybe use it the first 2 days, then the rest you kind of just follow instruction or chuarongo. You find your way.
Mm-hmm.
It's not complicated. Honestly, the road is straight for 500 kilometers. You know that it's sunny all the time. So sunglasses and sunscreen. I mean, we don't use sunscreen all the time, especially on this trip.
When you're doing safari, you don't need like the body lotion, just something for your nose. As you can see, for example, I am a little bit burnt here on my nose, and that's it. You need only this kind of protection. Other things are not really useful because most of the time you are with a t-shirt and you are in the car.
Yes.
Because safari is
in the car. Because safari, you're looking for dangerous animals. Even though you want to see them, you can't get close to them because they are dangerous, they are wild animals, so you stay in your car. And another important stuff for Namibian first visitors or first timers to Namibia is for all the safari in national parks, stay in your car. I mean, just because you have elephants, you have
lions. Do not try to do selfie with the elephant. That might cost you your life, so please stay in the car.
Anyway, guys, that was it from us today. We also wanted to highlight in this video that this trip was actually sponsored by Elite Travel Planners and Intermix Safari to Intermix. What the hell?
Final things, we wanted to remind you that all this Namibian trip that we had 15 days was sponsored by Intermix Safari and Tours, and we will leave in the description of this video all the information and the links that are going to take you to this Namibian tour operator. They are really, really professional. We advise really to plan your trip with them. Yeah.
Also affordable. I have to say they are affordable as well. Anyways, this is also our last day. Yeah. See you in our next video. If you like this video, guys, give us
subscribe.
Go ahead.
No, okay. I also have to say something. Come on.
Go.
No, please.
Okay, if you like this video, please give us I'm trying to start over, please.
The sun is setting, saying that.
But it's fine. This brings us to the end of the video, and this is also the end of our safari trip in Namibia. We are spending here a night in Waterberg Plateau Park, and then tomorrow we'll drive back to Windhoek and fly back to Europe. So if you like our video, please give us a like, subscribe to our channel, and most important,
leave a comment in the description. What would you like to see about Namibia? We have filmed so much content and we are planning to do a short documentary about the top amazing things to visit in Namibia. So stay with us. Ciao, ciao, ciao.